monster.
Hey guys, Konga here, and today I have 10 simple tricks to make you a better tanker. And these tricks are really simple. You don't need vast knowledge of the game. You don't need vast knowledge of your penetration. You don't need vast knowledge of how much armor people have when you're fighting them. You don't need to be smarter than the next guy. You don't need to be smarter than the guy you're fighting against. You don't even need to be playing this game long. You could be a brand new player and you can immediately put these to use. You really don't need knowledge, but these are literally going to help you win games. These are going to help you find yourself not needing to outplay a singular tank more so than I'm sure a lot of you find yourself now. You find yourself by yourself. You find yourself fighting one tank in a one-on-one, and then you lose a lot of health, or he beats you. This will hopefully help you not find that you find yourself in those situations and win for your team. All right, these are very simple tricks, and when we're done talking about this, we're going to go try them in a live game for you guys. Right now, we're just going to have a replay playing in the background. But 10 simple tricks, and we'll probably do some more than just 10 tricks, because I'll probably think of some other things as we do this. But number one is shoot to kill. This is my number one rule in World of Tanks, is shoot to kill. Don't sit there and be like, you know what? I'm looking at right now, in front of me, a Leopard 1, who is at full health, and an Object 140, who is a one-shot. I'm going to shoot the Leopard 1. No, shoot the 140, guys. Shoot the 140. Because, getting a gun out of the game means it is not shooting at you, it's not shooting at your allies, and on top of that, tanks can also spot, so it's not spotting you, it's not spotting your allies, it's not distracting you or your allies, and later, you won't have to waste a shot to kill it later, okay? If you can kill a gun, get it out of the game right now. Get it out. There you go. Dead. Out of the game. Number two is very similar to that one, but the number one does override it if the situation says so. Prioritize more dangerous guns. Yet again, if you're fighting against, let's pretend, a Leopard 1, we'll use that as an example again, and a K-91. Shoot the Leopard 1. Don't shoot the K-91. The K-91 is useless. Or a better example, we're just going to go with a Tier 9. If you're shooting, if you have a Tier 9 and a Tier 10 in front of you, shoot the Tier 10. Simple as that. This next rule is number three, shoot what you can penetrate. So this one overwrites the last rule a little bit. If you are fighting a Tiger 2 and an E-100 and you're in an IS-3, you may not be able to penetrate the E-100, so it might be better for you to kill his support tanks first. So in other words, kill the Tiger 2. When you start a game, you have to decide what role you're going to play. Are you a stock tank? Are you a bottom tier tank? Are you a top tier tank? Are you a tank destroyer? Are you a light tank? Who should I be prioritizing? And if you are bottom tier or minus one, maybe you should be playing the supporting role, meaning you should be shooting tanks that are supporting the enemy team, you should be flanking, you should be distracting, you should be making sure your top tier tanks can do what they need to do, or your fully upgraded tanks can do what they need to do. So in other words, if you have an E-100 and a Tiger 2 in front of you and you're in your IS-3, maybe kill the Tiger 2, then your entire team can focus on the E-100. But let's say you're in a Leopard 1. And there's a Tiger 2 and an E-100 in front of you, then you should be shooting the E-100. Unless, of course, the Tiger 2 is a one-shot. Remember, always shoot to kill. Number 4. Look at your mini-map. A lot. If you're using the compass map like I am, when you're not in the middle of a fight, do not be afraid to press that back button, that select button, that whatever button is on PlayStation 4, and take a look at the big one. Alright, just take a look at it, see where you are, see what needs to be done, see where you need to go. And just pay attention to where your team is. Don't lemming train unless it's absolutely necessary. Like, for instance, your entire team is going one way. What's the point of going elsewhere with, like, just to die? There is no point. If your entire team is going one way, then go that way too, is what I say. But if there are a couple people going one way and you think you can support them, then absolutely support them. Absolutely fight with them. All right, take a look at your minimap and look at it a lot. Number 5 goes with this one. Stay with an ally. Look at your minimap to know where you need to go. Look at your minimap to know where you need to be. Look at your minimap to know who needs to be supported, who's with you, who's not with you. And then number 5 is stay with an ally. Once you've looked at your minimap and you know where you want to go, make sure there's an ally with you. Make sure you have one with you. Whenever there's an ally with you, you're sharing damage. You're both putting in twice as much damage because there's two guns shooting, and you can get crossfires. This guy is reloading. He's decided to just salute And so I give him a salute as well. When somebody sticks their gun up, guys, stick yours up as well. Give him a good old salute is what I say. That's number 5.5. Number 6, any cover is better than no cover. Don't sit out in the open. If you can't find yourself moving, like you're in a position where you can't move, then at least find somewhere you can hide something on your tank. Something, anything is better than nothing. All right, any cover at all is better than no cover. All right, hide as much of your tank as you can whenever you can. The less of your tank that's being shot at, the longer you're going to stay alive. It's not rocket science. It's very simple, very very simple. Number 7, if it worked well last time, try it again. Try it again. See if it works again. Was it a fluke? Is it a solid strategy? Will it work almost every time? Will it give you a plus 50% win rate? Does it help your team? Does it keep you alive? You know, did it work? Let me try it again. That's number 7. And number 8 goes right in line with that. If it didn't work well last time, try something different. So, putting both of these together, if it worked well last time, hey, I went beach on Overlord and we won the game. Huh. Let me try that again. You know what? We lost it the next time. Maybe it doesn't work. So now you're sitting at a 50% win rate going beach. Try it again. You know, figure it out. Figure it out for yourself. What works, what doesn't work. And then you're going to have a good time. You're going to have a great time. You're going to win games. And all will be good in the world. Because if something works 1 out of 3 times, it's not a good strategy, guys. It should be working at least 50% of the time. Because you should have at least a 50% win rate. Because that means you're doing something for your team. And if you don't have a 50% win rate right now, then hopefully anything I'm saying here will help you. Anything at all. Number 9. Learn to sidescrape. For Pete's sake, if you don't know how to sidescrape, guys, go and get yourself a KV-1. A tech tree tier 5. The KV-1 is so easy to get. Go get it. Go play it. Go practice in it. Go figure out how to sidescrape. Maybe you don't want to do tier 5 right now because tier 5 is +2 -1 matchmaking. If that's the case, then go get yourself a KV-3. Learn to sidescrape. Get a T29. Learn to sidescrape. 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 Learn it. It is so important to learn how to sidescrape in this game. It will make you a really good player. It will keep you alive a whole lot longer. Absolutely. Number 10. Use a bush whenever you can. Guys, if there's a ridgeline in front of you and you plan to poke up on top of it to shoot somebody, if there's a bush somewhere, use the bush. A lot of the bushes do not work, but some of them do. And even if it only works 1% of the time that you don't get spotted, that's still 1% more likely you're going to survive. 1%. Is more than 0%, and maybe it will not protect you from being spotted, but it will still mask your presence to the point where they're like, okay, is he angled upward, is he angled downward, is that the back of his tank, is that the front of his tank, which way is he facing? Because a bush is hard to see through. You only get the silhouette of a tank, and it might be difficult to tell which way he's looking, who he's looking at, where his armor plates are, and that it will keep you alive as well. So make sure you do that as well. That's another good thing you can do. Is of course use a bush. And the last one, this is a bonus one, is you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Don't be afraid to just shoot your gun if you have the ammo for it. Anytime you think you might have a shot, just take it, unless of course it will spot you. But that's a more advanced mechanics there, and these are very simple mechanics. If you have a shot, take it. Don't be afraid to take it. So that's it. That's 10 things that'll make you a better tanker. 11, I don't even know why I mentioned 11, you miss 100% of the shots to do a tank. The reason being is because, all 10 of those things I listed, you do not need knowledge of the game for. The 11th one you kind of do because there are some situations where you should or shouldn't shoot, and you have to know. So I don't even know why I mentioned 11. Okay, so just ignore 11, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take, and focus on the other 10. And as I take a drink of water. So we're pulling out the T62A. The reason the T62A is because it's kind of a solid tank. It's not bad at anything, other than maybe gun depression. But it's also not the best at really anything. It's not overpowered, but it's a tank I'm very comfortable in. And so I think I can pull off some good games in it, and at least show off what I want to show off, which are the 10 things. And the first thing I want to do, of course, the order I listed you is of my opinion most importance. Looking at the minimap, I think is obviously one of the most important things you can do. But once you're in a fight, you're in a fight, and you're gonna fight no matter what when you're in this game, right? And so killing tanks is the number one thing you want to do to win a fight. But we're gonna look at our minimap and see where people are going. We have so many people going left, which surprises me, that I kind of want to scout here. Even though the base is on the right, it's not that hard to actually get back to base and defend it on this map. So I'm going to just make the bull run right now because of all my tanks pushing the left side. I don't usually make this play anymore, but two reasons I've decided this. One, no artillery. Two, my team is actually going this way. So I'm going to use the fact that my team are playing like this. All right, so that's what we're going to do. And I'm just going to try to get some spots out for my team right now. This is Jagdpanzer somewhere. He's probably sitting on the hill just waiting for me to overexpose. That might have been him, but I don't want to take that risk until I know it was him. So we're going to spot again. See an E75 who was actually the guy who we probably shot at us earlier. So, you know. Unfortunately, we have mediums right there who are going to keep me spotted. So this may not work so well. I wish there was a bush for me to poke up on that was safe to do so. Like, maybe this one is. Maybe. Except those guys right there. It is not. But we still tried to use the bush, which is one of the 9? Always, if you can use a bush, use a bush. That's what we've done there. And that's what we've tried there. The Jagdpanzer are still not spotted. So we're just going to keep lighting these guys up. Keep on doing it. We still haven't done anything. And we don't need to do damage to win the game. You don't need to do damage. I may not be getting assist damage either to win this game. But even just spotting these guys and halting them is enough to hopefully help us out. But there we go. We find ourselves a free shot there into the side of that guy. And we're gonna take advantage of it. That guy's not paying attention, so we might be able to put a free shot now into this guy. Yes, we are. Simple. Simple, easy, cheap, reliable. Paying attention to our map, paying attention to our surroundings, paying attention to where everyone is, and just putting free shots in. Their two heavies are dead, who are on my left. I almost want to make a play for this bull. And if I get hit by the Jagdpanzer, I get hit by the Jagdpanzer. But I think this is worth the play that we're about to make right now. Yeah, it absolutely is. If the Jagdpanzer hits me, he hits me, but it doesn't look like it. And now we're going to spot these guys. There we go. There we go. This is what I needed. And the Jagdpanzer is not up there. This is joyous news. Wait, there is a Lorraine, but there is no Jagdpanzer. We would have for sure seen him by now. There we go. Thanks for that, bud. And so now we're just going to be allowed to use our gun depression here and shoot this guy. The reason I shot him instead of killing the FV, the reason I did that was I prioritized the guy who's going to escape because I know that guy's not going to escape. He's not going to go anywhere. So I tried to get a little free damage in right there on the Lorraine. We were unable to do so. But now I'm going to switch my attention to who I can shoot at right now, which is this guy. We don't have any clean shots on him other than maybe his cupola. Let's take it. Of course, as soon as we do, we lag really badly. It's just the nature of the game. This guy shouldn't push me. Or push over. I think he's a little afraid. Finish him off. And we're going to continue on now. Because this guy is... he's just trying to spot right now. And he's got nobody covering him. So let's move up now. If he pokes up, my team will shoot him. And now we have easy shots on these guys. And we shouldn't have to worry about the other guy. And we're just going to put shots in the easier tank. That's the one closest to us. I think these two are platoon. They are. They're going to rush me. We shouldn't have to worry. We have to decide who we want to focus out. And that would be this guy. Especially if he pokes over first. We should be in the clear here. There we go. He is actually a little bit afraid to push, and that's because I do have allies. My allies are very strong. This guy just fired. Free, easy, cheap, reliable shot into him. Said no one as we bounce off his side armor. But as you can see, these guys are just going to get hammered if they decide to play. Yep, there we go. We put another shell into him. Light tank is coming. 50B doesn't want to play. This guy wants to face hug. He can do that. We're going to put it into his side instead. And then finish off this guy. Got to do it in his lower plate or his side. We get his side, but he gets finished off anyway. Jagdpanzer is spotted on the hill, so this 50B is in a position where we can shoot him without having to worry. As soon as we fire, we do hit a little bump. That's unfortunate, but it's part of the game. We're going to shoot this guy's tracks. Try to halt him. We do hit his tracks. We do not halt him. And now a Leopard prototype, or Standard B. I didn't look at his name, I just saw the shape of his tank. And I thought it was a Leopard prototype. But it was not, actually. We do not have the gun elevation for this. And there is still a Jagdpanzer, but Jagdpanzer is now spotted. And not looking. So let's put a shot into him. And we miss. He's now looking. And we can't pen that lower plate like that. No. I don't think this is a fight that is going to work well. We're going to head over to the middle now. As our conqueror gets ammo wrecked by the Maotian. I think this is where we need to go. We can get hold down here. This is the play I want to make. I don't want to push into guns that I can't penetrate and can just slaughter me. So let's not do that. They still have a full health. Well, not full health. Very healthy mouse and very healthy Maotian. And a Yagpanzer up on the hill. So I may want to go all the way around looking at my mini-map. That may be the play I want to do. The Yagpanzer are fired. That's not the play I want to do, then. Just easy shot there. There's the machine. Wow, that was a lucky shot. I wasn't expecting him to actually hit. And the machine actually hit that shot, too. Machine shooting premium, which I don't think those things have standard rounds, so that's completely obvious. But now we have the kill on him. Easy. He wasn't paying attention to his minimap. So we kill him. And now we get a free shot into his lower plate. We're going to use this Yagtiger. Yagtiger wants to take the hits. He can take the hits, absolutely. Now we're going to finish the kill here. And boom. Easy. He goes down. Now, we're going to wait. Because of the Yagpanzer. We're just going to wait a little bit here. I don't know where the Yagpanzer has shots. If he hits me, we're done. We can survive it, but I don't think we're going to survive the mouse. Alright, we're going to go. I'm going to put it in his cheek. Nice and flat there. Now we're very healthy, and he is not. I'm going to put another one in his cheek. We're getting good rolls. 264 pen on this gun. He's got 260 turret armor. So we got some good rolls there, and we're able to finish him off, or help kill him. He goes down. Yagpanzer is keeping us spotted, which means he does have line of sight on us. So we're going to move a little more to the right here, and he shouldn't see us now. But this guy has just killed our friend. But he dies for it. And that guy dies because he turns his side trying to shoot us. And we win the game. There we go. Cannot complain about that game. I think it went very well. We paid attention to our map. We were never alone. We used any cover we had. We used the bushes when we needed to. Let's take a look at this list and see what we did and what we didn't do. Okay. So, top 10 list. Here we go. We shot to kill. We got Top Gun. I'm pretty sure we shot to kill that game. The only time we quote-unquote didn't shoot to kill was this FE-215B when we tried to shoot the Lorraine. But I explained to you why I did that, and that was because the FE-215B had nowhere to run. We were going to kill him regardless. So I decided to get a free shot into the Lorraine just so we'd be lower health. We prioritized more dangerous guns. Absolutely we did. We shot tanks that we could penetrate. We didn't really need to do that in this game there. There was nothing like that at all. We looked at our minimap a lot. Yes, we did. We stayed with an ally constantly. Any cover is better than no cover. Yes, we did. We used rocks that game. The rock that game. We used ridges that game. We used the trains that game. If it worked well last time, try it again, and that would be the bull push. It's worked before seeing my team go there. If it didn't work last time, try something different. And that would be pushing underneath the bridge. We decide not to go there and go ahead towards the middle again because I thought my team would get slaughtered, which they did. They all died on that side. We side-scraped. No, we did not. We did not side-scrape that game. And we used a bush whenever we could, which we did, which was only one time, but still, we tried. And we fired our gun a lot, so 100% of the shots we don't tank. Yes, that is true, too. So there, we used pretty much everything except one instance, which was side-scraping. We never side-scraped. But other than that, we did everything we could that game and put our might and our effort into that game, and we were able to pull it off. But that's it, guys. I hope you guys all enjoyed. If you did, slap that like button. Comment, subscribe. Hopefully you enjoyed this and this helps you out a little bit, you learned a little bit, or it just reminded you of the basics that you need to be following and to win this game and to get a 50% win rate or higher. And hopefully that's the case here for you guys. But that's it. Make sure you go check out SpaceBANDIT and Koala Mentality's YouTube's links in the description below. And if you found this video helpful at all, let me know. I really appreciate those comments. They're my favorite comments, so let me know in the comments below. And I'll be seeing you guys all later. Take care, everyone. And peace out.